We're talking about specialized tours today. Welcome back to Shop Talk. Now, if you're a photography buff and would like to take snapshots of the beautiful tourist spots in the country, you may want to join Backpack Photography's photo tours and workshops. And to tell us more about their group and what they do is Ferdz Decena. Hi, Ferdz. Welcome to Shop Talk.
Yes, good afternoon. Thanks for having me here.
Okay, you've been like a freelance travel photographer and a writer and a blogger. How did you come to think, okay, well, with this background in my work, I want to take people on tours, specifically photography tours?
Well, it started when people were inquiring on my blog on how they could join the places I've been to and also some lessons for photography. So my friend, I had a friend then who travels with me, so we conceptualized backpack photography for that and tested the waters and started with Banaue. And people were, we had good responses for that. So that's when it started, the first tour we had, which is in Banaue.
Right. Okay, yeah. What are the other destinations aside from Banaue, the rice terraces and that? Where else do you go?
We had Batanes, and also we also had one in Lake Cebu in Mindanao for our tours.
All right. And what's included in the tour? You do give workshops as well. You give a lot of tutorials and instructionals on how to take better pictures.
We actually have differentiations on our tours. First, for the photographer for Banaue, that's a photographer 101 workshop, which is more an instructional on the basics and fundamentals in photography. And for the other photo tours, it's more of a guided tours, not much on the technical aspect, but more in taking people and the guests, participants at places at the ideal time. And also, of course, we're there, so we can get to give our tips and if they have questions on how to set the camera or how to, any technical aspect, we can be there to guide them during the shoots.
Right, and is it the same for the other locations?
Yeah, it's the same for all of the locations. That's how we do our photo tour.
Right. Mm-hmm. So even if somebody's a novice, they can come in and take the tours together with somebody who's maybe a little more advanced.
Yeah, even beginners. We actually have guests who only have point-and-shoot cameras with them, but they were able to learn, and after learning what the big cameras or the advanced cameras can do, they wanted to upgrade.
Yeah.
Because they appreciate what they can do with the camera, with what they can do with the photography, what they can do with other things.
Right, with more advanced apparatus. Having said that though, you were saying to me during the break that you don't necessarily have to have an SLR camera to take good pictures or to join the tour.
Even small camera, it's more in the eye of the person is taking the picture, so that's what you can train. But of course, it's a hand-in-hand thing. A good camera can produce good pictures as well, but you also have the knowledge. You also have to, it's like what they said, the engine and the arrow. It's about the same. It has to be a relationship between the camera and the user. So as you progress as a camera, as a photographer, your camera also progresses with you.
Okay.
So if you're starting from point and shoot, so after a while you would find that the settings, the capabilities, features of the camera wouldn't be, you're already past that.
Yes.
So you have to use a bigger camera.
Right. You realize the limitations. As a photographer, you become more advanced.
Yes.
Right? Okay. So on average, how long, how many days and how many nights do your tours last?
For the Banaue, it's only 3 days, 2 nights. But for the Batanes, we have an option for 5 days and also 7 days.
Right, because it's a longer distance.
Yeah, it's a farther place.
Right, mm-hmm. Okay. And what's the price range for taking a tour with you?
For the Batanes, for the 5 days, it's around 17,000. Mm-hmm. Inclusive of all the meals and accommodations.
Okay, so that's everything.
Yeah. For the 7 days, it's around 21,000, 20,000.
Okay, so again, it makes sense. It depends on the length. And is it a seasonal thing, or you do this all year round?
We do this all year round. We, even during the rain rainy seasons like August, October, off-peak seasons, we can do that since we're not dependent on the weather.
Yes, yes. And I guess interesting weather events also make for interesting pictures, yeah. Right? Yeah. Who are the type of people who take your tours? Are they locals? Are they foreigners, expats?
Usually we get locals, but we also get some foreigners, OFWs, who like to explore the Philippines.
Okay.
And more on enthusiast photographers who really want to take pictures, not unlike the tours they go to, because it's a difference between going to a tour and going to our tours, because we specialize the itinerary for the photography.
And you really stop at the spots where, you know, you're gonna
even if we have to wake up early in the morning, like 4 a.m., we have to do that so we could capture the golden hour.
Yeah, okay, so what is the golden hour? From what time to what time?
Usually it's early morning, around 5 to 9, 5 to 8, and then late afternoons from 3 to 7 p.m., around those times.
Right.
And in the afternoon, we can just sleep in them.
Take a nap. Before you take all your pictures. Mm-hmm. What's the feedback you get from your guests?
Ever since we started, it's been fulfilling, because most of the participants on the first tour, we had them on the next three tours we had after that. So it's nice because they're coming back again and again for the tour.
So you have, repeat clients.
Yeah, we had repeat clients.
Wonderful. Okay. How far in advance do your guests have to book?
For the international tours, for the like Batanes, we had to book in advance, like 1 month, at least 1 month, so we can assure the slots for the plane. And for the Banawe, it's maybe at least 2 months.
All right. And what are other locations you're considering for your tours?
we're looking into El Nido this summer around May. And possibly we're looking also for an international photo tour.
Oh, where would you want to go internationally?
Probably around Cambodia or Thailand.
Okay. All right. And what feedback have your have the people taking your tours given you? What have they said?
What have they said? Well, usually they like that they learn a lot more, because they can apply what they learn immediately, unlike in the classroom where it's more theoretical.
Right. Okay. And are you the only one taking them on the tour, or
no? I have a friend who's also a blogger, and there are two of us who are co-facilitating the tour. And also, I have to mention that we try to limit the number of people who's going to the tour, like 10 to 15, so it's more intimate and it's more of a one-on-one discussion with the participant, unlike the big groups that you can't monitor what's happening to every one of them.
So how big is your biggest group? I mean, how many can you accommodate at most?
At most around 15, probably. 15, 16.
All right, so please invite everyone to your next tour.
Yeah, we have the... We actually have a Batanes this whole week, but it's already full.
Oh, so booked up already.
Yeah. The next one we would be having is this June for Banawe. And the next one for Batanes again is in August.
All right, so lots to look forward to. Ferdz, thank you so much for Shop Talking with us
today.
Thank
you very much as well.
And thank you for watching Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco-Trillo. Join us again tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your day.